Vous êtes avec SBS French. Retrouvez les rubriques sur sbs.com.au/french.
Donc, j'ai le plaisir de recevoir April Phillips, qui vient de gagner un prix au Festival international du film de Melbourne, le prix Uncle Jack Charles pour son film Kaju Yanaga. Et c'est un film qui a une connexion avec la France. April Phillips, bienvenue au programme français sur SBS.
Salut.
Parlez-nous de Kaju Yanaga, ce film qui raconte une histoire aborigène, mais d'une façon différente. C'est une expérience inédite. Parlez-nous de ce film.
Oui, Kaju Yanaga, c'est Rema Grow, 14 meters, and it's an invitation into the spirit realm. It's a wonderful way for audiences to come and join a First Nations experience and enjoy that kind of interactive experience as well.
When you said it's really big, that it's projected on a 14 meter wide screen, long screen, and it's an angled screen, an unusual screen. It's really big and exceptionally presented and has a connection to France. Tell us about that connection to France.
We couldn't find in Australia the technology we needed. So can you believe it? We needed to go to France. We needed to travel to Lyon. And the organization is called Augmenta. And they have cutting edge body tracking. So infrared light that tracks bodies in real time as data that we see on the screen. So for example, we see our spark, our blue spirit represented in the story.
One thing we have to mention is the type of movie that it is. It's an XR storytelling experience. Explain to us what's XR storytelling.
Yeah, so XR can mean lots of different things, but in this case, you would say it's immersive. In French, how would you say immersive?
Immersive.
Immersive, there you go. Immersive experience.
So que les auditeurs peuvent se plonger dans l'action et faire partie du décor, faire partie de l'action. En fait, quand vous avez parlé de Augmenta, ce capteur qui capte les mouvements et qui, en fait, en temps réel, aussi projette des images dans l'écran et vous fait vous intègre dans le film lui-même. Et vous avez dit que cette technologie elle vient de Lyon.
That's right, c'est ça. That's right, yeah.
And did you think about this technology, having to source it from overseas before you embarked on the project, or it just happened organically, you had the idea and then your team looked around and said, the only place you can find this is in France?
Yeah, we had to search, and it meant that our collaborator, Jordan East, had to go and travel to Lyon to go pick them up and understand them further. And he had a wonderful time, he said, by the way.
No, Lyon is a beautiful place in the central France. It's not far, actually, when going towards the south, the best part of the country, where the weather is always beautiful. And tell us more about the idea behind the film and the story that you tell, and how you managed to bring in First Nations traditions and tell them in cutting-edge technology.
It's only 10 minutes, so It doesn't feel like a long time, but it feels like longer and shorter than that at the same time. But the story is sort of about joining the spirit realm and thinking about this kind of future, this possible future, but also acknowledging the deep past. So Kaju Yanaga is in deep time, we would say, and also circular time. So it's ancient and futuristic at once. And we also experience day and night time twice in the work. So that kind of messes with us in a cool way where we're not sure how time is passing, which is really beautiful. But we're really exploring this idea of intergenerational healing and thinking about how we come out stronger on the other side. Once we've done the work to overcome our traumas, we are shinier for it and stronger for it.
How do you... I've seen it. I have my own way of exploring it, and I'll go back second time to see if I can discover some other layers. What's the best way you would recommend viewers see it?
Yes, well, it's here at ACME in Melbourne until the 31st of August, so just a few days left. And I think when audiences arrive here at ACME to experience the work, they'll find themselves sort of within a story. It's so large, it feels like you're inside it. You can join the play space, we call it, which is the sort of the black area on the floor. And when you move, your movements are represented on screen. Or you can also take the time to sit and observe the story. And some people like to do both, actually, to play in the work and then to watch the work afterwards, because it's hard to see everything in just one.
So every viewing is different.
Exactly, yes.
Wow. When we leave this place, I'll go back and play with those. And sometimes it's scary when you see this landscape coming towards you. It's massive. And, oh, wow, this is, yeah, it's big. And you think, why is he going to fall over the cliff? And there is this character moving on the screen.
Mm.
This is a real human movement. You had to have someone walk and then maybe make CGI around the person? Or how did that? Because the movements are natural. It's natural steps and the flow, the dance, and whatever movement they are making on screen. These are natural movements. They are not like these cartoon characters. It's just naturally flowing movements.
Yes.
Is it an actor you used?
Yes, it is. So it's actually Warren Foster Jr., one of the First Nations collaborators, who is Ewan, and we put him in what we call a mocap suit with, like, little sensors all over his body. So on his arms, his shoulders, his legs, and there's gloves. And it means that every movement he makes is captured. And then we have the companion spirit, the 3D figure that we see, and we have bones inside of it, and then we match both of the bones. So there isn't anything the companion spirit in the work does that isn't actually an embodiment of Warren Foster Jr.
And out of all genres, why did you choose this one?
Out of all the what, sorry?
Genres of movies and storytelling.
Yeah.
Why did you choose this one?
I feel like it's the most cutting edge, the most fun, the most ambitious, and really we're kind of entering this domain which hasn't been fully explored yet. So maybe First Nations peoples could be the pioneers of this space. Wouldn't that be exciting?
Well, you're the first First Nations creator actually in this space, and maybe one of many more to come, I believe. I hope so as well.
I hope so too.
Yeah. Et pour Philips, merci infiniment d'avoir pris le temps de nous rejoindre sur SBS French. Thank you very much for joining us on SBS French, April Phillips, and congratulations again on winning such a prestigious award.
Merci beaucoup.
Aimez, partagez, commentez. Suivez-nous sur facebook.com/SBS French.